have you guys tried climbing a hill on your 450x Ather? I have around 1.5 years old of second generation of 450x Ather, which in general offers me a range of 80 to 85 kilometers in cities. But how well will that perform while climbing a hill? Let's check it out today. So today, we are gonna climb from bottom of the hill to top, which is around 9 kilometers, and check the performance of the bike. We are starting to climb the hill and the roads are getting steeper, and I can feel the bike starting to take more load now. Also, I forgot to tell you that we are two people riding the bike. Me and my cameraman. We both together weigh around what, close to 140 kilos. Along with, we have a couple of bags which has this recording gear. So in total, we are around 140 to 150 kilos and we are riding this bike to Nandi Hills now. The location, guys, it's absolutely spectacular. But back to bike now. I can actually feel the motor taking load now. The range has been dropping faster in comparison to what it did on the highway. When we started the climb to the hill, we had a charge of 77%. So let's record the charge and the range which will be left once we reach the top of the hill. For now, we have charge and there is a charger on top of the hill. So let's just enjoy the ride and talk about the bike. For every turn, for every climb this bike is making, this bike just makes me wonder that what a performance of the bike. I mean, practically speaking, yes, the motor is taking a hit. Yes, the range is taking a hit. It is taking a lot of load. But still, the bike is just pulling very comfortably and very easily. But I have a doubt. Will the same performance that we are getting in sports mode, will we get the same thing in eco mode while climbing the hill? So we tested all the four rides while climbing the hill. Eco, ride, sports and the warp mode. And the results just completely stunned me. When we tried the eco mode, I was expecting the bike to stop somewhere in between while climbing the road. But actually it didn't. I mean, this ride mode eco, it has the least acceleration. There was a little struggle, very little in comparison to sports mode, but the bike just pulled it off. Amazing. Ride mode was a bit comfortable than eco mode. Sports and the warp mode was just, the bike was just flying. I mean, there was no issue in terms of the performance of the bike whatsoever. Talking about the comfort of the bike, climbing a hill is actually pretty comfort on this bike, which I did not expect. This bike feels under control and will love riding this bike. In fact, what is very surprising is that the road grip of the bike is actually pretty good. I mean, for this wheel size, which is not too broad, the grip that you are getting while climbing a hill is absolutely amazing. Along with that, these tires offer you amazing braking experience. You'll absolutely love and you can rely on the brakes of this bike while climbing a hill. So finally, we have reached the top of the Nandi Hill and here is the charger. We are lucky that the charger is actually vacant. But the app shows that the charger is actually not functioning. I was expecting this charger to be under repair. But this seems to be working. Let's try it out. Oh yes, it is actually working. The app shows it is not working though. I think it's got to do with the signal on top of the hill. Oh my god, did you guys see that? When we started our ride at the bottom of the Nandi Hills, the charge left on the bike was 71%. And now we have only 47% left. That is a drop of 24%. Usually, in sports mode, for 24% of charge, you will get a range of 14 kilometers. But from bottom of the hill to the top is only 9 kilometers. So we spend that extra 5 kilometers simply by climbing the hill. You see, while climbing the hill, the motor takes the load. And this is what that load looks like. For riding a distance of 9 kilometers, you have to spend charge of 14 kilometers. That is what climbing a hill looks like on Ather 450x second generation. But that's not as bad as I thought. Because while riding back from top to the bottom, we probably might not even need to accelerate the bike. Let's see how it goes when we get back. There is one more cool feature with your 450x Ather. You can regenerate your charge. All you have to do is to grab your accelerator and turn it to the other way around and it starts regenerating. But the problem is you can't know if it is regenerating and how much you have regenerated because none of your Ather app or the dashboard will show you this. The previous time when we rode the same hill, we rode for 9 kilometers from top to bottom, regenerating all through the way, and we were able to regenerate 2 kilometers. 9 kilometers of regeneration gave us only 2 kilometers. Yes, that's right. Because it's very less, and we now have a charger atop of the hill anyway, we have decided not to regenerate this time. But if you want to know the impact of regeneration and how do we do it, you have a video right over here. So this time around, no regeneration, just enjoy the ride. So, in conclusion, how was the ride? The performance of the bike, the comfort, everything was amazing. But how about the range and the charge left in the bike? While climbing the hill, we spent 24% in sports mode, which is equivalent to 14 kilometers just to climb 9 kilometers. But while coming down, we spent only 2%, which is equivalent to around 1.5 kilometers. So, if you think about it, we rode a distance of 18 kilometers in total, spending only close to 17 kilometers of charge and range. That's very equivalent to what you consume on a flat road in a city, right? It's not much a difference. So now, what do you guys think about this trip? Have you tried this before? If so, please do let us know in the comments below.